I said hygiene, and your teeth kind of have plaque on them. So.
My first time reacting to a Pop the Balloon, episode 26. Let's see. Uh-oh. What is this? Is that the only guy who got a match? Is that why they showed him? Oh, never mind. This is a cool intro. I can't even lie to you. I'm not gonna lie. I just said I can't lie to you. I'm not gonna lie. Oh my f***. I'm cooked. Not his shirt saying him. Does she have a husband? Oh, she got a ring on her finger. Yeah, she do. Not the... with the mic? You know, I've never actually watched a full episode, bro. I've only ever seen clips. And them be pissing me off, so I know I'm about to... I don't know, man. I might get upset with this episode. Let's see.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. It's your host, Arlette, and we are here with another episode of Pop the Balloon or Find Love. And we've got some single men lined up. Make some noise, guys. Okay, I don't know what that was.
That was cold, bro.
We continue. So we're going to be bringing out some single women one by one. When she comes around this corner, if you're feeling her, she's your type, down to a T, do not pop your balloon. However, if there's anything you're not feeling, whatever that may be, go ahead and pop your balloon, and I'll go over to a few of you and figure out why you ended up popping. Are we ready?
Oh, yeah. Let's do it.
Okay, y'all were a little quiet in the beginning. Okay. Okay, if we're ready... let's go ahead and bring out our first single lady.
This is awkward, low-key. It's just silent.
Hello, welcome in. What's your name?
Hi, I'm Barbie.
Barbie, how?
Pop. Next.
I'm sorry. How old are you?
I am 24.
And what do you do?
I am a full-time nursing.
How old are you?
I am 24.
Do you see how she spells Barbie? Baribi?
Four.
And what do you do?
I am a full-time nursing student, and I cocktail serve here and there.
Okay, yeah. Nice. What are some things you like to do for fun?
More like working out, tennis. Next year, I'd like to travel more.
Nah, she don't look bad. I'm just trying to joke out for the memes, bro. Things,
honestly, I'm not really picky.
Got it. Now, what
nobody really popped their balloon anyway.
Just honesty, caring. Generous, just family oriented, all that stuff.
You know, a lot of, I feel like a lot of girls say they want a generous man until they actually have a generous man and don't want them to be generous.
Okay. Now, what are some of your deal breakers?
Kids.
Okay.
Kids. And then just someone that lacks communication, and also
it's always communication.
Just like to stay in the house, okay, like all the time. Too much of a homebody.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got it. But, yeah. Okay, so we did get some pop balloons. Let's go on over there.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. I probably would have popped the balloon off the homebody thing too. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro, because like low key, I hate this like stigma about homebodies, bro. I hate how people hate homebodies, bro. Just because I'm a homebody doesn't mean I won't go out and take you on a nice date. It doesn't mean I won't go out and have a good time with you. It just means I prefer to stay inside. That's all.
Let me see why they ended up popping. All right, let's start over here with your name and age.
I'm Gerard, I'm 26.
Okay, and Gerard, what do you do?
The fit tech
guy. I work in the cyber industry. By the time this airs, I'll be a data scientist.
Damn.
A personal training company and do some career consulting.
Okay, nice. So why did you end up popping your
Louis Vuitton?
I'm definitely a homebody. So I'm in the house a lot. When I date.
As a tech person, slash for me as a content creator, bro, I understand. It's like I kind of have to be in the house.
I kind of like compromise and schedule dates out, but yeah, I'm a homebody for the most part.
Yeah,
I mean, I am too, but I'm just saying, like,
then what the fuck is that? Why is that a red? Why is that a deal breaker for you then? Why is that a deal breaker for you then?
If your date night is Netflix and chill, then I'm just not.
Yeah, that's not my date night. But, yeah.
But
yeah. See, that's what I'm saying, bro. That's why it's better to articulate what you mean by that, bro. Because me and him are the same. I'm a fucking homebody, but that doesn't mean I won't take you out on a nice date. And he just said that same thing. He said, that's not my date night. I'm going to take you out for real. But I am a homebody. Literally exactly the same. She talking about some damn, oh, I don't want a homebody, but okay. I'm a homebody too. I just don't want you to be like our date nights and Netflix and chill. That's not what that means.
So is Gerard someone that's your type?
Yeah, he's really cute. I like the facial hair. I like the tattoos a lot.
Sorry, y'all. You can't say homebody then. If that's the case, you can't say homebody. Your deal breaker should have been somebody who never wants to go out. Somebody who never wants to take me out. Something like that, bro. You can't say homebody because that doesn't mean they don't take you out. It just means they prefer to be inside.
Yeah. That's okay. Really cute.
Did she say body?
Hair. I like the tattoos a lot. Yeah. Okay. It's really cute.
Thank you. Yeah, you look good too.
Thank you.
Let's go to our next pop balloon here.
That's what I'm saying. He didn't pop the balloon because he thought she looked good and she seemed nice. And then she said the homebody thing. I would have popped too.
Your name and age?
My name is Quan. I'm 29.
And Quan, what do you do?
I'm a mechanic. I'm a technician. I fix stuff.
Okay, cool. So why did you end up popping your balloon?
I'm a homebody. I like the Netflix and chill. I'm going to be honest.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, he don't cute, take nobody
like,
out.
After, like, maybe, you know, you get to know each other. But yeah. In the beginning, it's nice to, like, you know, do things and stuff like that. But, yeah.
Okay. So no dates. Just Netflix and chill all the time.
Oh, no, we do dates, definitely. You know what I mean? But, I mean, she said that homebodies, that was something that was a deal breaker. So, you know, for me, that's something I take pride in. I work hard. I'm a football coach. I'm a baseball coach. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when it comes to being home, I work hard to afford a home. So,
exactly. Why am I paying this much money for rent if I'm never home? Like, bro, come on.
Okay,
I like
to that's
take
cool.
pride in it. All
right. Sounds good.
So, is he someone that's your type?
No, but
girl? Oh, no.
No,
why not?
But, bro's a girl. I like more of like a low cut.
Okay. She don't like dreadhead niggas.
And
it's okay,
you know,
girl.
Just put more effort more. But...
I think this nigga right here just popped the balloon because she just said, I like a low cut. And he said, yeah, she don't like dreadhead niggas.
But that's
okay.
It.
He gonna pop his head because he got braids in.
So she my type? What we doing?
Is she your type?
She cool. She beautiful. Don't get me wrong. Girl, your body.
Yeah,
model.
Thank you. I appreciate
but
it.
But you're not my type.
Okay.
simply because I just feel like for me to be with you, it would be too much. As far as like, you know, you don't want a homebody, so you're going to probably want to keep up with the Joneses and, you know, me.
I didn't say I didn't want a homebody. I said I don't like someone that just stays in the house. Like, if I tell you, oh, I want to go out and get cute and stuff, and you're like, oh, but we can watch this new movie. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, I wouldn't tell you that. See,
but
me?
But I'm not saying that I don't, because I'm in the house.
See, look, here's the thing, bro. She low-key fucked herself over. She low-key fucked herself over by saying homebody. And that was my point prior to this, is that you can't say homebody and then also be a homebody. Because then you're going to get niggas who are saying like, well, I'm a homebody, but like that doesn't mean I'm never going to take you on dates. That just means I prefer to stay in the house, which is what I said. And she low-key just shot herself in the foot with that one.
Most of the time. No problem. But... you know?
All right. Let's go to our other pop balloon. Thank you. Okay. Let's get your name and age.
My name is John. I'm 27.
And John, what do you do?
I'm an attorney.
Why did you
I also
pop?
Model and I have
she said she didn't like
well.
Niggas with long
okay,
hair.
So why did we end up popping our balloon?
Well, she said she likes a low cut. I think you're very beautiful, by the way. Body's amazing. But she said she likes a low cut and I have long hair. So.
I told you. Bro, this fucking... Yo. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. So you get to the low cut thing, but is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But is it the hair, like you said earlier, or is it something else?
The outfit? Yeah, it's the hair, but It's the outfit too.
Wow, bro. I didn't pre-watch this. I swear I didn't, bro. I just know superstitious people when I see them. I'm not going to lie to you, bro. I'm not going to lie to you.
Sure. Giving like Michael Jackson a little bit.
There's nothing wrong with trying to dress like Michael Jackson. That nigga was rich as fuck, loved by so many fucking people.
You're cute.
Thank you.
Yeah. Also, that's not really giving Michael Jackson.
And right over all right. Here, your name and age.
Justin, I'm 26.
Justin, what do you outfit. Do?
I'm a data analyst.
That shit probably expensive, nice. Though.
Why did
that
you end up popping your balloon?
Same thing. She said she likes a low cut. I have longer hair. And I don't plan on cutting it anytime soon. So that's why I popped my balloon.
Okay. Got it. But is she someone that's your type, apart from her saying that?
Yeah, I think she's very pretty. Yeah, I think she's very pretty.
Okay, got it.
Now, not her moving the shit out the way so she can show her boobies.
Yeah. Even with the hair?
Yeah, even with the hair. Probably the nose ring, but he's cute. He's cute.
There's nothing wrong with a nose ring. I kind of want one. But I wouldn't do like a ring. I would do like a stud.
Matthew, 26.
And Matthew, what do you do?
So I work in tech as an inventory manager, and then I DJ and fitness model on the side.
And bro's holding on to a toothpick. He's a fidgeter, bro. He's a fidgeter, bro.
I have very long hair, and I'm not going to cut it anytime soon. So
he has long hair.
Yeah, you do,
it. Yeah?
Okay. And now, is he someone that's your type?
No, but you're really handsome.
Thank you.
Just no. Yeah.
Just no? Okay. Yeah. And then over here, your name and age.
Okay. You know, I don't think she's that bad compared to all of the clips that I do see. She's saying like, hey, this guy's not my type, but he's not ugly either. I appreciate that, because there's that one girl, I don't even remember her name, bro, but there was this one girl where she tried to play that one dude that was from Chicago or whatever. Everybody knows that clip, bro. It went viral. I think it was one of the first viral clips of Pop the Balloon, and she was talking about some, I don't like how you try to put the fake flower in your suit trying to make it more than what it was, and blah, 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 and she always had some shit to say about the guys. It does make it look like he has a noggin.
My name is Sylvester. I'm 26.
Sylvester, what do you do?
I'm in government contracting, so I own an intermediation business. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Okay, cool. And why did you end up popping your balloon?
So, she says she likes long hair. I respect that.
I mean, short hair.
I have long hair. So
you mean short hair?
I just want to give you what you respect, you know?
Of course.
Yeah.
She's like, everybody got long hair. Bitch, your type is not in here.
Yeah, they all have long hair.
Right, there's quite a few of them. Yeah, we got
it's okay. I mean, he got a low cut. He didn't pop his balloon, did he?
He's really cute. I like the jacket.
I think he did.
Really like the outfit.
I appreciate it.
But, why she like that rugged look, bro? I think she likes that rugged look because she said she likes his outfit and she liked the other guy's outfit. And he was like dressed like a mechanic too, bro.
The jacket. Really like the outfit.
The wife beater is crazy.
But
jacket over wife beater is crazy.
And over here, your name and age.
My name's Daytrian. I'm 27.
And what do you do?
I work for Maricopa County Sheriff's Office, and I also own my own tax business.
Nice.
Oh, this nigga's a sheriff?
Why did you end up popping your balloon?
Just kidding.
So she's very beautiful. The thing was, the homebody thing, I don't know. I'm split between that, but also you say you didn't like his outfit. I like his outfit, and I like to explore fashion, so if I...
Bro, riding for the bros. He's like, you know, I like his outfit. And you don't like his outfit, but I like to explore fashion, so I would wear some shit like that. And the fact that you don't like it, boop.
Come out with something and you don't like it. Come out with another outfit you don't like it. I like my woman to, you know, like me and hype me up. So it's kind of, you know, I don't know. I just feel like that would knock my confidence down. So
I see what he means. I mean, I get it. You don't want a girl just like pegging you down, bro. Pause. Whoa.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Not popping over another man's clothes is kind of wild. That's why she just laughed like that.
Confidence down, so.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Yeah, that's cool.
Okay, now is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay, why not?
I mean, just no, yeah.
I respect it.
Yeah.
Okay. Now she trying to be weird, bro. Yeah, she hurt, bro. Now she being weird, bro. Talking about some, nah, fuck no, he not my type. Because he don't like you. But secretly, deep down, he is your type and you're mad because he don't like you.
He just seems like he's very combative.
What? What? I feel like girls just be saying anything when they get hurt or rejected, bro. Combative? What?
So, yeah.
Look, he's not even being combative. He's not even being combative, bro. He just stayed silent. You don't know what you're talking about. What the fuck? What? Where did you get combative from? Oh my goodness, bro. Girls be hearing words on TikTok and just throw this shit around, bro.
We do have a unpop balloon down there. Let's head on over.
Look at her. She's so mad.
All right. If we can have your name and age.
My name is Jared. I'm 27.
And Jared, what do you do?
I'm a corporate compliance analyst for a global insurance company. Very
cool. So you do have your balloon unpopped. Why so?
I like to take the time to hear people out. I ain't gonna lie. The homebody thing, it shook me up at first, but you expounded upon that and said that you would just like somebody that has some duality, which I can appreciate. The hair comment, still a little 50-50 on. I don't know if my hair too long for you or not. I do cut it sometimes. The waves be on swim, but.
You love waves.
For sure, for sure. But yeah, I'm just.
I'm trying to hear more.
Yeah, okay. For sure.
All right. So is he someone that's your type?
He's really cute. I like his hair. I like the earrings, the beard and everything. Again, the whole body thing, I just like someone who likes to like live life. Like I want to live
that
life. But yeah.
Oh my god. Yo, that's crazy. Yo. This man just popped in her face. That's crazy.
Okay. Why did we end up popping in the end?
He's trying to humble me.
I just said, no, it's not even that. I just said I respect the whole homebody thing. Like, I'm not really a home.
Yeah, he just. Yo. Yo. Oh my gosh. That's crazy. Oh my god. Bro, dead ass said. I swear. Bro said. He said. Bro, what the fuck? What the fuck? Yo! Nah, that's crazy, bro. That's crazy, bro. Okay. Hear me out. I know why he popped his balloon. I know why he popped this balloon before he's going to explain it. I know why he popped it. Because he literally just told Arlette. He kind of does look like Zeke. He just told Arlette. He said, you know, the homebody thing kind of shook me up at first. But then she explained how she just wanted somebody who has duality. And I respect it. So I kind of want to just hear her out. And that's it. Right? And instead of hearing him say that and understanding what he just said, he said, she goes on and just listened to respond and goes, again, the homebody thing. I just want somebody who lives life. But did you not just hear me say that I understood what you meant? So let's see what he says.
No, it's not even that. I just said I respect the whole homebody thing. Like, I'm not really a homebody. Like, when I'm to myself, I chill. But if my shorty want to go do something, we're going to go do something. So. But the fact that I felt like she was so hung up on the homebody thing, I didn't want that to be a point of negation or anything.
Okay, I got it. All right, well, thank you. Let's head on back.
She ain't getting no match.
All right, well, that is.
Bro, imagine you in a room of, hold on, 1, 2, 3.
Let's head on back.
4, 5, 6, all right, 7.
Well, that.
Imagine you're in a room with 8 niggas. And not a single one of them chose you, bro. Or the same thing with women. Imagine you're in a room full of 8 different women as a nigga, and none of them choose you. Like, that gotta be embarrassing, bro. Yeah, we gotta see that again. Hold on. 10:52 is where we at.
His hair. I like the earrings, the beard, and everything.
He likes staying focused.
The whole body thing. I just like someone who likes to like live life. Like I want to live life. But yeah.
Okay. Why we end up popping?
Yeah. Nah, bro, that's crazy.
All right. Well, that is all of the balloons popped, unfortunately. But we do thank you for coming on. Let's go ahead and give it up for her, guys. I'll take this. Thank you.
I didn't even see her walk out.
Thank you.
Look, at some point, I don't remember how old she was. I don't. But at some point, you got to realize that looks go out the window at a certain age. It's good to have standards. Don't get me wrong. It's great to have standards. But you can't think that just because you look good, you can get whatever you want. Because at some point, these niggas don't care about looks. Because at some point, these niggas grow up and they realize looks is only for if I'm just trying to smash and that's it.
All right.
I'm not gonna lie, this is gonna be a long ass reaction. I've been recording for 21 minutes and it's only been 11 minutes. Golly.
Hello. Welcome.
I just got a lot to say. Yo. I'm Brianna. Nice to meet you.
Hello. Welcome in. What's your
name? Oh my God. I'm sorry. My camera is in the way. Oh my God. My camera is in the way.
Hello. Welcome.
Yeah.
And what's your name?
Oh my. Yo. Oh my. Yeah, she got a good body, bro. She
goes to the gym. Nice to meet you guys.
She definitely goes to the gym. There's no way.
I'm 22. And what do you do?
I'm an actress, video vixen, model.
Video vixen.
Isn't that interesting?
Now, what are some things
I guess that makes sense.
For fun, I love to travel. Okay. I like athletic stuff, like swimming.
I told you she in the gym.
Working out.
You can tell.
I like cooking.
You can tell when it's a BBL and when it's a gym body, bro. I'm not going to lie to you. It's so obvious.
Like, you know, cooking together. That's fun to me.
Nice.
I like anything, really. Anything spontaneous.
Okay. Yeah. Now, what are some things you like look for in a man?
Look at her from her knee.
I want my man to just...
I'm, like, overanalyzing. But look, from her calves to her knee to her, like, thigh, you can tell she in the gym, bro, for real.
Be for me.
I'm sorry about my camera, guys. But also, y'all can see it when it close up on her.
I want to be friendly, like, with
look
my
at that shelf,
too.
Bro. It's kind
of
crazy.
I don't mean friendly like that, but, like, you know, just take care of both of us.
Okay.
I had a lot of issues with that. I also want my man to just take care of himself. Like, hygiene is very important for me.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Okay, what are some deal breakers?
Kids.
Kids?
Yeah. Every girl come behind here and say kids.
Oh, that's the only one?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
So, we don't have
a little
any...
bit open.
I knew. You know, every time I say that, somebody always pops. Let's go on over here and see why he ended up popping. All right, let's have your name and age.
Justin, I'm 26.
Hi, Justin.
And Justin, why did you end up popping your balloon?
Just too young for me. She said she's 22. This is a little out of my age preference.
Okay. 4 years?
Makes sense.
I mean, now, she may not be mature enough.
Someone that's your type.
Don't say no because he popped you. Don't say no because he popped you. Don't be one of those.
No.
And why not?
Just because...
He popped the balloon.
You look really clean and everything like that, but I don't know. It's just something. Maybe
because he popped the balloon. Just it's all right to admit that you popping. You said he's not your type because he popped a balloon. It's okay to admit you're spiteful. You know, that's a thing you can do. It's called self-reflection, self-awareness. You know, maybe one of those two things you can use.
Maybe it's because you popped it for me. Maybe that's why.
Oh, she said it. Hey, man, I'll take it back. I'll take it back. We love a girl who can take accountability. Hold on, give me my balloon back. Yo, that's crazy.
That's fair.
Okay. That's fair.
I bet you he probably going to take that balloon back. I bet you going to be like, wait a minute, let me get that balloon back. I would have.
Okay, we got one.
Oh, come on, nigga. That was kind of funny.
Quan, 29.
Okay. And Quan, why did you end up popping your balloon?
You indecisive, baby.
I am indecisive.
Yeah, see, I need a woman that's decisive. Okay. Like, I need...
Yo, Yo, these are fucking crazy. I can't lie. This shit is kind of crazy.
To be able to take charge where I can't. So what you just did pretty much showed me that you're not ready to lead.
Okay.
In areas where you're supposed to.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. That kind of look at this nigga's face right here, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. That kind of felt like you just attacked her like a motherfucker. Like I get, like I kind of get what he's trying to say. Don't get me wrong, I get what he's trying to say. Like nobody really wants indecisiveness, but like that kind of felt aggressive, my nigga. That kind of felt like he was attacking her.
Okay.
Okay. So now is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay. And why not?
I said hygiene, and your teeth kind of have plaque on them. So.
Yo.
On the bottom ones.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Okay, let's head on back. We did get a pop back.
Look at this nigga's smile.
Hygiene.
The one with Michael Jackson. Kind of
have plaque on them, so.
Yo, just he really and did look away like entirely.
So.
Yo, nah, this is gonna be a short. This is gonna be a short, bro. I gotta make this one a short. Oh my goodness.
The bottom ones.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.
Bro right here is trying his hardest not to laugh too. Look at the smile, bro. Look at the smile. Yes.
Okay.
Oh damn, bro.
Okay.
Damn, yeah. Bro.
Thank you. Okay, let's head on back. We did get a pop back here. Your
no,
name and age?
Not you.
I'm Sylvester, 26. I'm okay. Sorry.
And Sylvester, why did you end up popping your balloon?
She said, no, not you. She really liked this guy. That sucks.
So, like, I'm somebody that wants to have somebody that knows what they want. Okay. I know you say you're indecisive. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's a process to it. But I'm looking to build, not rebuild. You know what I mean?
Ooh. I love how this nigga's respectful with it, though. I like how he's respectful with it, though.
So, I smile and think about it.
Okay, well, that's something I'm working on.
Working on it never fucking works, bro. I'm just... When somebody says, I'm working on it, it never fucking works, bro. You have to... It's a difference, bro. When someone says, oh, that's something I'm working on, that is, every time I've ever heard that shit, bro, it's always a lie. When someone says, you know what, I'm gonna do better, then it's different. But that I'm working on it. Look at him. Look at when she said that, this nigga said, like, bro, look at this.
I smile on me. Think about it.
Okay. Well, that's something I'm working on.
Working on.
You're right. You're so right. I'm sorry.
All right. So
you're right. You're so right. I'm sorry. Sylvester said, yeah, I dodged the bullet there.
Now, is he your type? I know I heard you say a little something, but is he your type?
Yeah, he's my type. I just don't really like the nose ring.
No, I feel that.
Okay.
Yeah. We got a pop over here.
She's very... Look, bro, I'm not going to say nothing, but for talking about hygiene, her teeth ain't the prettiest either, bro. I'm not going to lie to you. It's like...
Your name and age?
Matthew, I'm 26.
Okay, and Matthew, why did you pop your balloon?
My nose is pierced.
The nose ring? I know.
So, yeah.
All right, so I know you said nose ring is like a little for you. Is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay, and why? Is it the ring or anything else?
Outfit.
I don't really like your outfit.
Yeah, I figured.
No worries.
No worries. Nigga said, I don't care.
Okay.
The silence is speaking volumes, bro. The silence is speaking volumes, bro. Look.
I don't really like your outfit.
No worries.
Okay.
in your hair.
Okay.
Yo, this episode is this is crazy.
Go on down. I think we had one. Yeah, we did. We got one over here. Your name and age?
Gerard, 26.
Gerard.
And why did you end up popping your balloon?
So I was waiting to hear you explain the indecisiveness thing. When you told him, you didn't really give a specific reason. So that in combination with your age, not something I'm looking for.
Okay, to answer your question, I feel like I'm really spontaneous. So me being indecisive has something to do with that. Mm-hmm. If that makes sense.
Yeah. Do you know what you want out of life?
Do you know what you want out of life? This crazy question, bruh. I can't, bro. I love this episode. Yo, maybe I really gotta start watching Pop the Balloon more, bro. This shit is hilarious.
Yeah, I know what I want.
What is that?
I want to be an actress, and I want to just live, like, on the fields. Like, I'm sorry, not the fields. The country. Like, I like the country.
She like this bitch. Don't know what you want.
Everything like that. And, you know, like, with my family.
Yeah. Yeah, I just.
I'm sorry, I'm a little nervous.
Yeah, you're good. You're good. Yeah, I just have a clear vision for what I want. So I want a woman that can kind of match with that.
Okay.
But yeah.
Okay.
You got to realize, like, some of these guys, they're older, like 26, 27, 26. It's like they kind of want, like, a mature woman, bro. Not saying that she can't be mature, but, like,
so
I don't know.
So now is he someone that's your type?
He could be.
Oh.
He could be. It's crazy.
So what makes him not? You say he could be, but what's making him not be?
The hairline. She keeps staring at his fucking forehead. It's gotta be the hairline.
You do look a little older, but how old are you again?
26.
26. You look older than 26, yeah, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He does look a little bit more mature.
And over here, we got a pop. Your name and age?
I'm John. I'm 27.
Okay.
Hi, John.
And John, why did you end up popping your balloon?
So I actually didn't think that you were indecisive or anything like that. I think, you know, maybe it might be the nerves or something.
Yeah.
But for me, it was like, the lifestyle that you said you wanted to live, like the countryside, farm and all that. I've lived in the city my whole life. I'm not a country person. Like, I've tried it and I just wouldn't succeed in that. So just wanted to pop and not waste time.
Okay, no problem.
Good shit, bro.
And now is he someone that's your type?
No.
No.
Okay, why not?
He looks a little gay.
Look at Arlette's face, bro. Look at Arlette's face, bro. Look at his face. I'm not gonna lie, these girls is out here disrespecting this nigga, bro. First bitch said he looked like Michael Jackson, which I don't think is a diss, but like she trying to mean it as a diss, and then she said he looks gay.
Wow.
Sorry.
Okay.
I mean, if you're not, it's okay, but...
I mean, I'm here.
I mean, if you're not, it's okay. Bitch, he...
Wow.
Sorry.
Okay.
I mean, if you're not, it's okay.
I mean, if you're not, so you're just expecting him to actually be gay and just...
But...
I mean, I'm here, right? Like...
So to confirm, you like women. Like,
yeah.
He's on this lineup.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And I think, did we get a pop back here? Oh, yeah, we did. Let's head on back there.
That's crazy.
Your name and age?
Again, I'm going back to what I said with the first girl, bro. Just because you got a nice body, just because you look good, doesn't mean shit anymore, bro. I promise you that. These guys want somebody with a good personality, know what they want. This nigga still ain't pop his balloon.
My name's Daytrin. The reason I pop my balloon.
Is he the last person?
Again, it's the lifestyle that you want to live, the country lifestyle. I grew up in the country. That's a closed chapter in my life. Kind of like the city now, suburban area now. So that's just something that doesn't interest me anymore.
Yeah. I like the suburbs. That's nice.
That's all. It's just the country part.
Okay. Got it. Is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay. Why not?
It's because he popped. She be trying to find something. She be trying to find something. I feel like she doesn't actually think half of these niggas look bad or are not her type. It's just that she just be trying to find something.
I don't want to come off rude.
There we go.
Just be honest.
Okay. It's just your teeth. Cool. And your haircut.
Okay.
His haircut's fresh, bro. It's probably just because his lineup is kind of far back.
We have one unpop balloon down there. Let's head on over there.
That's not really his fault. Okay.
Well, he's straightening out. All right, your name and age?
My name is Jared, and I'm 27.
Hi, Jared.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Okay, so, Jared, you do have your balloon still unpopped.
Again, because he likes to hear people out.
Why so?
I think she's very, 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 very attractive. So, yeah, I'm just trying to hear out, see where I'm at.
All right, so, are you telling Jared? Nigga. Is he someone you... Jared, you're the first man, you know? Yeah.
You said you're nervous too. It's okay.
I was a little nervous, but we good now.
Okay. Yeah.
We good now.
Any questions between the two of you?
What do you do?
I'm a corporate compliance analyst for a global insurance company.
Okay, nice, nice.
You said you have another question?
This nigga pissed.
I don't have one.
No question?
You have a question?
Yeah, I got a few. So, number one, where you from?
I'm from Maryland.
What part?
She from the Northeast. That's why she like this.
Howard County.
Okay.
Columbia, Maryland.
Okay, I'm slightly familiar.
Oh, yeah?
Number two, you said you like to cook. So what you like to cook?
Everything. I like to try new things. Okay, all right. If you're looking for a specific answer, I really like to make baked chicken, cilantro rice.
I swear to God, if you say Alfredo, that balloon is getting fucking popped.
Any type of vegetable. I really like broccoli. That's my favorite.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then third question, I promise I'm done after this.
No, you're good.
But where do you see yourself in the next, like?
Ooh, he's probably going to pop right here.
Let's say like 2 years.
In the next 2 years, I'll be 24, planning marriage, dating. I want to be dating like from now until then. Mm-hmm. And then I want to like start thinking about having kids, you know. I want to be... like looking for a house, or if not in one, because you know I live in an apartment. So, yeah, just having my life a little bit more together when it comes to that. You know, my life is together, but in that instance, in the love life instance.
So you feel like from what you said you're doing now, like as far as career wise, you feel like you'd be able to transition from out of that within the next couple of years?
Yeah. Well, yes. Just I want to stay acting though, but I'm into real estate. So I'm probably gonna be doing more of that, like in between. Mm-hmm. But acting, it's my passion. Like I love it so much. Like
that's fine.
Okay. All right. Let's come on up here. Come on up, y'all. Come on up. Come on up.
Okay, we gotta fucking match.
I still have to keep walking backwards.
No, you don't have to. I mean, you can walk however feels comfortable for you. All right.
Hey, bro. He kind of walked out with a mess. He kind of walked out with a bad bitch.
Hey, right, so we got a couple questions out the way down there. Any.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. Them shoes is thick as fuck, my boy.
Final one. It's not by force.
You don't feel like I'm a little too old for you?
Mm-mm. You don't look too old.
Touche.
Okay. Touche. So with that being said, is it a yes?
Wait, his arms was crossed. I didn't see.
You gotta come. No, you don't have
to. Bro is pissed.
Stay down there.
A little too old for you?
Mm-mm. You don't look too old.
Touche.
Touche is a crazy answer.
So that being said, is it a yes for you for her?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it a yes for you for him?
Yes.
We got a match.
Hey, man. Hi, man.
I'll take this
mic. You just got... Hi, man. Yeah. Okay. I'm done. Hey, man. You got yourself a good one, bro. I'm not gonna lie. She look good, bro.
And you guys can go on up. Let's give it up for them, y'all.
Good God.
Take this mic. Good. Oh my. And you guys can go on up. Let's give it up for
I'm doing this for the homies again. This is not just for me.
Them, y'all.
Good Bro, mad.
Step for them,
called
y'all.
Him gay, bro. Bro, call, yo, imagine one of the baddest walks in the room and says, you look kind of gay.
All right, let's go ahead and bring out our next single lady.
I don't know, bro. He's not giving. I don't know, man. I don't think he's giving off a gay vibe, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you. I don't know why she said that, low-key.
Hello, welcome in. What's your name?
I'm Paige.
Paige, how old are you?
I'm 24.
And what do you do?
I'm a grad student in a health science program.
Okay. Now, what are some things you like to do for fun?
I'm very adventurous, so I like outdoors, nature.
Wait, I just remembered they be showing Instagram. So this girl that's on here, that one that was just on here, I know she got a lot of follows after this.
Luxury experiences.
Okay.
Traveling.
All right. Yeah. Now, what are some things you look for in a man?
I look for amazing communication. Okay. God-fearing, hardworking.
Hold on.
That's about it.
She got a ring on her finger?
All right. Now, what are some of your deal breakers?
No personality, no accountability, no reliability.
A long ass.
That's about it.
Whatever okay. The hell that is.
All right. So we haven't got any pop balloons. So I'm actually going to switch it on over to you. So let me hand you a pick. There you go. And I am going to have you pop, let's go with two balloons. Based off of what you're seeing, whoever doesn't really fall into your type too much, go ahead and pop those two.
She didn't do that with the other girl. Damn.
Okay, and then one more.
Damn.
All right, let's start over here. Okay, your name and age?
Daytrin, I'm 27.
Okay, and why did you have your balloon unpopped?
Everything she was saying, you know, fits what I look for in a woman, so I just want to keep hearing her out more. She's very beautiful.
Okay, got it. So why did we end up popping his?
The outfit. Put it up to your mouth.
No physical attraction. That's
ooh.
It.
That's okay. Fair.
All right, got it. And then we have one more over here that you ended up popping. Your name is
Matthew, 26.
And Matthew, why did you have your balloon unpopped?
I liked your answers. I'm also adventurous. I like to travel, that kind of stuff. So,
got it. So why did you end up popping his?
Physical attraction. No.
Like what?
It's just the outfit. It's not giving what I needed to give. That's it.
That's me, bro. If I heard it's not giving what it needed to give... I'm not gonna lie to you, bro.
Okay. All right, thank you. Let's head back. So we do have 5 balloons left unpopped. Go ahead and ask these remaining guys a question.
What do you do for work?
Okay, what do you do? Name and age, what do you do?
So my name is Sylvester. I'm 26 and I do government contract.
Nice.
Name, age, and what do you do?
My name is Justin. I'm 26, and I'm a data analyst.
Nice. He does look good in the face.
Your name and age, and what do you do?
My name is John. I'm 27. I'm an attorney. I also model, and I have a podcast.
Love that.
He's a podcast, bro.
Your name and age, and what you do?
I'm Gerard. I'm 26. I work in the cyber industry, and I own a personal training company.
Your name and age, and what do you do?
My name is Quan. I'm 29.
She said, that's some good chocolate right there. She said,
crazy. Your name and age, and what do you do?
My name is Quan. I'm 29. I'm a mechanic. I do personal training, and I'm a football coach and baseball coach.
Cool.
All right, I'm going to stop trying to, I'm going to stop pausing so much because I'm already at a 20-minute difference,
bro.
So
after those responses, I am going to go
ahead and 24 minutes. I've been recording for 44. I'm done pausing.
All right, so why do we end up popping his?
I liked everything you said, quite honestly, and I like the dreads. It's just a little slimmer than I prefer.
Okay. I can pick you up 5 different ways.
I bet you could.
Don't even worry about that. You could.
I had to pause because, bro, what did you just... I'll just right, talk.
So
I'll
why
just
did
talk.
You have your balloon unpopped, Quan?
She's gorgeous, you know what I'm saying? Look at
that
you,
is
your hair, your eyes. Your smile,
that's
everything about you, but your age kind of scared me, so I just wanted to hear more of what she said.
Word, how old are you?
I'm 29.
Okay.
Hold up. Whoa, what was that?
Nothing.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, let's head back.
I don't remember how old she was.
Let's ask these guys another question.
Does anyone have kids?
No kids.
No kids?
No kids. Do you have kids?
No.
No kids. All right.
No children.
All right, any other question?
What does dating you look like?
That's actually a decent question.
Like? Let's start down there and work
that's
our way back.
That's a decent question. I actually can't lie to you.
All right, so what does dating you look like?
So I'm big into self-improvement. Mm. So when I'm dating someone, I always try to, how do I explain it? Give them ways to become the best version of themselves. So like if you're going to school, so I would figure out or talk to you about what goals you want to accomplish. Other than that, I'm a romantic guy, so
that's nice.
Going on trips together.
Yeah, she seemed pretty decent.
I have a homebody for the most part, but I compromise and schedule out dates. And when I do go on dates, it's nice. We go to nice places, so yeah. And I'm a empathetic guy, so anytime my girl is stressed out, she comes to me and, yeah, I relieve that stress.
Yeah. All right.
She did not laugh at that.
What is it like dating you?
So I'm a pretty faithful person. I'm Christian. So I like to center my relationships around God. You know, I want someone who is God-fearing as well, that we can, you know, if we have problems or anything, we could take it to prayer, things like that. I'm also a romantic person, so I like to surprise you with flowers, you know, things you like, things like that. I like spending quality time. So, you know, anything that we can get to know each other and get to spend time with each other, that's pretty much what it's like.
Awesome.
Okay. What is it like dating you?
Dating me is like, it's just fun. I like to have a lot of fun. I think I like to incorporate a lot of spontaneity in my relationship. So I like doing.
Okay. Hear me out. The fact that she said this nigga is gay, or the fact that she said that this nigga looks gay and not him.
Awesome.
Okay. I mean,
what is it like?
I don't think he looks necessary. I don't think he looks necessarily gay. I think he sounds kind of, you know.
Dating me is like, it's just fun. I like to have a lot of fun. I think I like to incorporate a lot of.
Like, do you hear what I hear? Like, do you hear what I hear? I'm just.
Spontaneity in my relationship. So I like doing, you know, like I've gone on trips where it's been like a week in advance. I know about it. We go on a trip. Like, so I like to do very spontaneous things. Just keep it fun, keep it fresh. So dating me is very fun. That's what I'd say.
And I also feel like I see a lot of gay people in this shirt, bro. Look, bro, I'm not even trying to be like that. I just feel like I see it a lot. I'm not even trying to say anything like that, but
last
I'm just saying.
Guy, what is it like
for you to
you?
Say that dude looked like he was gay kind of didn't really make sense to me. I don't know.
Got the pressure. Yeah, I like to make things easy, you know.
I like dating you.
So it's a breath of fresh air. Yeah, I like to make things easy, you know what I'm saying? I'm a provider. So if you're somebody I'll provide for, you don't got to worry about nothing.
Damn, I said I was going to stop pausing it, and now I'm back at a 20-minute deficit.
These are all really good responses. So it is time to pop a balloon. I am going to have you pop two balloons.
Two. Damn. Arlette, Messi.
Okay, damn. And then one more.
It's going to be the dude at the end, because she didn't make her laugh.
Oh. Okay.
Indecisive.
Let's start here.
Indecisive.
So, wait a minute.
That nigga popped in four.
Popping his.
Sorry. I don't want to.
Sorry, microphone.
I'm just going to say, I love your braids.
Thank
That's cool.
Thank you.
But the outfit, maybe.
I feel that it's me.
That black tee.
Yeah.
It's not even a tee, girl.
Yeah.
It's a beater.
Maybe if we bun it up.
I feel that. It's me, though, you know?
Okay. Love that.
Mm-hmm.
All righty.
I'm not going to change who I am for you, girl.
Over here. Why did we end up popping?
I wanted to hear what she had to say, but I kind of, the grad school thing was it for me. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've gone to grad school myself. I know how much of a commitment it is and how much work it is, but I would rather have somebody that's, you know, been in the field, like, worked before, know what that's like. And I think I'm just looking for somebody to kind of match me and where I'm at rather than matching somewhere where I've been before. So I think that's why I popped my balloon.
You're talking about undergrad or graduate school?
Graduate school. I have my master's degree.
Awesome.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Good shit, King. Good shit, King. Good shit, King. You know, did you see how she low-key try to play him? You'd be like, you mean undergrad? Nah, I meant what I said, bitch. Graduate school. I got my master's. I love that, bro.
You're talking about undergrad or graduate school?
Graduate school. I have my master's degree.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay. So is he someone that you
love that?
You don't look bad by no means. Where are you from?
I live in New York, but I'm from California.
Okay.
All right. So we do have two guys left. Any questions, guys, for our lady here?
I don't know. She's cool, right, but like the way she just tried to play him by saying, you mean undergrad?
I talk to my mom every single day. I talked to my brother before I came here. I check on my family frequently.
Like 30 minutes in.
Despite me just moving, you know, and uprooting my life, I'm very family centered.
So where are you originally from?
I'm from Louisiana.
Oh, okay, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay, any questions here?
Yeah, just add on that. Where do you live now?
Here.
Oh, okay, got you. I was going to say, how do you handle being told no in a relationship?
That's an important question.
It's really about the circumstance. I can really put my guard aside if, you know, it's warranted. I take criticism, so I'll be a little sad. I may give you a little attitude, like, whatever, but I mean, I guess.
She like him.
When you graduate with your master's, what is your plan after that?
I'm going where God takes me and the money.
Period.
That's a good answer.
That is a good answer.
Yeah, so I live in Baltimore, Maryland. Yeah, I don't know how you feel about long distance.
I'm actually not mad at it. Like he said, I'm pretty busy Monday through Friday, but, you know, on the weekends and breaks, I have like to have a time, so.
So you can hop on flights.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, gotcha.
All right.
That boy like her, bro. Okay.
It is time to pop one of their balloons and see which one is your match.
Oh, shit. It's down to those two.
I love Jesus, too. I just want you to know that. I love Jesus, too. I just want you to know that. I love that you said that. I'm here for it 100%. Honestly.
Okay. Sure. So why'd you end up popping?
Honestly, I just wanted to hear what you had to say. You said you popped his balloon because you said he was like slim. I'm a pretty skinny dude too. Like you probably can't tell because of the jacket, but yeah, I'm a pretty slim guy. So like, yeah, I probably wouldn't be a good match for you.
Okay.
So is he right? Is he your type? Or
I like your voice. That sounds nice.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Well, Gerard, come on up here. Come on up, y'all. Let's head up here.
I knew it. I knew this was going to happen.
So any final questions between the two of you?
Yeah, I do have one question. So if I look on your Instagram, is it a lot of thirst traps? Are you showing a lot of skin or?
Do I look like I show a lot of skin?
I don't know. You never know these days.
No. Okay. Very covered. Mm-hmm. Follow me on Instagram.
Yeah. I mean, we're matched, of course.
You guys, you're good. Okay. Well, with that being said, is it a yes for you for her?
I just don't like the way she just answered that.
Oh my god, bro. Oh my god, I'm gonna crash out, bro. Dude. I get it though. It was just a simple question like, hey, is there a lot of thirst traps? And then she was like, do I look like I show a lot of skin? Like, there's a little bit of attitude right there.
For you, for her.
I just don't like the way she just answered that.
I can't lie to you, bro. I kind of agree.
Pretty much. I really don't.
What was wrong with
there, that answer was like, really, I see it, bro. I see it a little bit.
But how she answered it?
It was like the, do you like the way I, like, I just.
Do I like the, what did I say?
It was the way you said that. You were like.
It was like, do I look like I?
Right, because she was wondering why you asked that question.
Like that.
I mean, you don't present like that, but I feel like it was a reasonable question in today's society. I just don't like how you.
I can't wait till you see it.
Yeah, now she giving attitude. Yeah, bro. Good shit.
All right, well, let me have you head on back. I thought we were there. Why'd you do that? All right, so that is all the balloons popped, unfortunately, but we do thank you for coming on.
What am I doing?
On.
Watching Pop the Let's Balloon for the first time?
Let's give it up for her, guys. I'll take the mic. Thank you.
God, I'm in a 20-minute difference, bro. It's a 30-minute video. I've been recording
okay,
for 55.
Okay, let's go ahead and bring out our next single lady. Hello, welcome in. What's your name?
Samaya.
Samaya, how old are you?
I'm 25.
And what do you do?
Official state.
I'm a licensed EMT and I'm in school.
Wait, what did she just say? Official stay pretty.
How are you?
I'm 25.
And what do you do?
I'm a licensed EMT and I'm in school.
Oh, nice. What are some things you like to do for fun?
I like to go on hikes and I like to go to the gym.
Okay. Now, what are some things you look for in a man?
I can't lie, I don't like her. I don't like the way she like drags her words out. I'm licensed EMT and I go to school. I don't like that.
Someone who has boundaries, someone who knows what they want. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Now, what are some of your deal breakers?
Someone who's a liar, someone who doesn't know how to communicate.
Communication is the only thing they talk about.
All right, so we don't have any pop up.
For someone saying someone who doesn't know how to communicate, I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
She just like doesn't articulate well. For someone whose deal breaker is someone who can't communicate, her articulation is so bad, bro. Oh my goodness.
Any pop balloons? So I'm actually gonna switch it on over to you. So let me hand you a pick. Have you hold on to that. And I am gonna have you pop. Let's go with three balloons.
Three.
So based off of what you're seeing, whoever's not really your type, whatever it is, go ahead and pop those three.
Okay.
Girl, hit hard. Go.
There we go. Two more. And one more.
Damn.
Let's start right here. All right, your name
They love
age.
Homie with the Justin, him jacket 26. On, bro.
And Justin, why did you have your balloon unpopped?
I just wanted to hear what she had to say. Okay. Yeah.
But is she someone that's your type?
Not necessarily. I just wanted to hear more what she had to say. I don't really go just based off pure attraction. Okay. So I like to hear
that's
what
good.
People have to say and, you know, get a taste of their personality as well.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, man. Hey, man. Just because you light skin don't mean you look good. That's all I'm going to say.
Why did we end up popping his?
Based off, like, everybody else, it was, like, least attraction.
Mm-hmm. Got it. And then we did have one more over here. Your name and age?
I'm John. I'm 27.
And John, why did you have your balloon unpopped?
John, I just wanted to hear out what she had to say. I'm attracted to, you know, mind and body and soul and things like that. So I just wanted to explore that a little bit more.
Okay. All
right. Same.
Why did we end up popping his?
I'm not really attracted to his, like, eyes.
You know? Bitch, my eyes? Hey, man, could this show be any more shallow, bro? My fucking eyes?
And when you look at somebody, it's usually like eye contact. Mm-hmm. It's just not really. Yeah.
She said your shit is too close to your nose, bro. Then she's trying to say it nicely.
Sure.
And then there was one more down here. It's too close to your nose, bro.
I'm Quan. I'm 29.
And Quan, why did you have your balloon
unpopped? Boy, nervous?
She gave me Zoe Kravitz vibes. So I just wanted to hear her out a little bit. You pretty.
Thank you.
You're gorgeous, but I just wanted to hear you out. So.
Okay. And Zoe Kravitz is crazy.
I would say same. Like, when I look at him, it's just not really, like, an attraction.
Okay.
Like, eye contact-wise. Yeah. And
okay.
His lips.
Okay. What about the lips?
He smoke, so they black.
I don't know. I wouldn't kiss them. No offense, though.
No offense taken.
All right, thank you, Quan. Let's head on.
She
back.
Is really looking him in the eye. I can appreciate okay. that too, but it's like,
so we
damn.
We have four balloons left unpopped. Let's ask these remaining guys a question, whatever question you have.
How old is everyone?
Mm-hmm. Okay, and what else?
We have kids.
You know, okay, I was gonna say that too. I didn't want to say it too early, but I was gonna say this nigga creeped me out because he looked like YNW Melly, bro. I got murder on my mind. I got murder on my mind. Okay.
And kids. Okay. Name, age, and do you have any kids?
I'm Daytrin. I'm 27. I don't have any kids.
Okay. Name and age. Any kids?
Yeah. Sylvester, 26. No kids.
Same thing here. Your name and age, and do you have any kids?
Matthew, 26. No kids.
I'm in the studio, bro.
Last guy over here. Your ball name and me, age, and do you have any kids?
Gerard, 26. No kids.
Gerard, 26. No kids.
Do you have any kids?
I don't have any kids.
No kids.
Why,
okay,
bro, say it so like that, bro?
These guys. Actually, no. I am going to make you pop a balloon.
Pop another one?
Yes.
Damn.
Let's go ahead and pop one more balloon.
Pop another one.
Okay. Kind of hard.
Okay. It's because I'm an EMT.
Can I ask another question?
Next round.
Okay.
Okay.
A pop his.
It's all right, bro.
All right.
I guess
so
you're not
why
him.
Did we end up popping his?
I got murder on my mind.
Just an attraction is not really there.
Okay. What is there something specific?
No.
Not really.
Of course not.
Why you laughing? Okay.
Because so there's no reason.
How old are you?
I'm 26.
26.
You said that already.
Okay. You look older.
Yeah, I've been told.
Yeah.
Shit, bruh.
I mean, it's not a bad thing. I don't like older guys, but. Just a little older. Yeah.
Okay. So why did you have your balloon unpops for her?
I really wanted to hear more and okay. possibly ask some questions, but yeah, physically, she looks good. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. Yeah. All right.
I don't really mean much.
We have three guys left. Let's ask okay. them another question.
When I first walk out, what is like the first thing you notice? Like, why do you still have your balloon?
Okay.
Yikes.
Let's start over here.
I'm not even going
to. So she said, what was
I
the
noticed
first
that
thing
cross
you noticed
on your arm.
Why you still have your balloon up?
She has nice lips, good skin, good smile. So. Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Same thing here.
Yeah, your aesthetic fits mine. That's it.
Okay. What's that aesthetic?
Just somebody who's chill. Okay. You know, artistic. You seem like an artistic person. So that's pretty much it.
Yeah. Okay. And over here?
She wasn't fucking with that answer.
You're just very beautiful. I like your outfit, and you just have an athletic build. So you know, I like that.
Okay.
Why'd she say okay like okay. that, bro? It's pissing me
Three
off.
Three guys left. Okay. Go ahead and pop okay. another balloon. All right. So we heard why he still had his balloon. Why did we end up popping his?
Because you said my aesthetic, right?
He no. said your aesthetic.
Oh, you said my aesthetic. What did you say?
Athletic build.
Are you fucking serious? That's an instant pop for me, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. That's an instant pop for me. You can't remember what I just said to you 5 seconds ago? Instant pop for me, bro.
You say you're very beautiful, athletic, man.
I don't know. Like, I mean, all of them basically say, like, how I look. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's basically all you have to go off of. But.
You asked what did they notice? You asked what they noticed when you walked out. What are they supposed to say? Oh, I noticed your personality when you walked out the fucking room before you said anything? All right.
I don't know. Yours was just more...
Not specific or...
I don't know. It just was not what I was looking for. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So our two guys left. Any questions for her? Okay. Let's start here.
So, whenever you're going through something, you know, any kind of trouble, what do you tell yourself to get you out of the funk?
Trust God.
That's all I need to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Amen. All right. Any questions here?
What is your biggest goal in life?
My biggest goal? To do whatever God wants me to do.
The last girl who said that did not get a match.
Honestly.
You good? You look like you're...
I mean, like, I... Okay, here's the thing, bro. I understand why people say that, but at the same time, that's not, like, a good enough...
Okay.
That's not a good enough answer.
All right.
Wherever
so,
God takes me...
It is time to pop
that means
balloon.
You don't have a real plan.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, go for it.
That's fine.
Okay, so why did we end up popping his...
Attraction. It just wasn't really there.
Okay.
And yeah. What was it for you?
His head is smaller than mine. I feel like it's valid though.
So you think he has like a small head?
Yeah.
Okay.
What is my head? What the fuck, bro? What does my head size have to do with anything, bro? What does the size of my fucking noggin have to do with anything, bro?
Well, not small head, but it's like smaller than mine. I have a big head.
Yeah, he had to pop his shit too. Cause like, bro, what the fuck does my head have to do with What does my head have to do with anything, bro?
Okay.
Yeah.
That's big at all.
It'd be different. It'd be different if she said like, oh, his head shape is a little weird because that nigga got the little alien shit going on because he got his dreads tied up like that. But his head is small? What the fuck does the size of my head got to do with anything, bro?
Really?
No.
maybe it's like my own.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Let's go over here. So why'd you end up popping your balloon?
It may be a dumb reason, but just the reason you popped is. You're looking at me crazy. I understand.
No, I feel like that's valid. I feel like that's valid. You popped your balloon because you said his head was small. The fuck? So I'm gonna pop my balloon because you popping your balloon on his because his head was small?
So like for me,
that's
you know,
a stupid
you may
reason.
Find me attractive or whatever it may be. You know, like if I get into a car accident or something, my head gets smaller. I know you're not gonna be there for me. You know what I'm saying?
It's okay. Yeah. I probably was gonna pop yours anyways.
No, that's fine.
Okay. So why were you gonna pop his?
Probably like his mouth, teeth. Mm-hmm. Like it's just not really attractive to me.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah.
I couldn't wait for her to leave. I'm
all
not
right,
gonna
so
lie.
So that is all of the balloons popped. But we do thank you for coming on. Let's give it up for
laughing.
You guys. Anyway. Thank you.
Yeah, I couldn't wait for you to leave. Goodbye. Goodbye. These niggas just laughing.
Okay, let's go ahead and bring out our next single lady.
I couldn't wait for her to leave either, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
Lou,
she's tripping.
Welcome in. What's your name?
Emaya,
how old are you?
I'm 24.
And what do you do?
I'm a makeup artist and I do private chefing.
Oh,
private
nice.
Chef.
What are some things I like to do for fun?
I like to garden. I like to cook.
Say this again. If I ask you what you cook and you say only chicken Alfredo.
I do like beauty things. I like to do my nails, hair, makeup.
Awesome. She did say okay. She a private chef. So.
Now, what are some things you look for in a man?
I look for a gentleman, somebody that actually wants to be a man. Consistency. Someone that's not a liar.
Mm. Yes. Okay. Now, what are some deal breakers?
Children.
Mm, every okay. fucking girl, bro, who has walked in this room
that's the biggest one.
Okay,
has said children.
It. So we did get some pop balloons. Let's head on over there to see why they ended up popping. Let's start
even,
here with your
he
name.
Don't even got, none of them got they don't, none of them got children, and they still popped after the children thing. That's crazy.
I'm Daytrin. I'm 27.
Okay. And Daytrin, why did you end up popping your balloon?
I'm just not attractive. Okay. Like, you're pretty. I'm just not attracted to you. That's all.
That's,
was there anything specific?
No. Just I mean, she's just not my type, though.
Okay. All right. And now, is he your type?
I would say yeah.
Long ass nails.
Going over here to our next guy. Your name and age?
Matthew, 26.
And Matthew, why did you pop your balloon?
I just don't love the tattoos. That's all.
Oh my God, I did notice he took his fucking jacket off.
Respect it.
Yeah.
All right, now is Matthew someone that's your type?
I would say no.
Okay, and why not?
I don't know. I would say...
Just not
you
physically
just don't
attractive.
Look as I don't know, you just don't look like someone I would, I guess, entertain if you approach me.
And that's fine.
Of course.
It's okay to say that stuff. Here. I don't know why they're so
your
scared.
Your name and age?
I'm Justin, I'm 26.
Okay, and Justin, why did you pop your balloon?
Just attraction, not really attracted.
Okay, now is there anything specific?
No, nothing specific, just genuinely not, generally not attracted.
Okay, got it. Now, is he someone that's your type?
No.
Okay, and why not?
Just not attracted.
Okay.
That's
and
fine.
What about him?
I don't know, just not, when I look at you, I just don't
feel anything.
Attraction feeling.
I think it might be to hear it too. Right. She got the whole Medusa vibe going on.
What's
I'm
going
not
over
lie.
Here? Name and age and why you ended up popping your balloon.
My name's John, I'm 27.
Bro,
and
the
I pop my balloon. First off, I love your hair and I love your dress. Like,
never mind, it's not the hair
color, so I know that would go well with her. Mm-hmm. It was just really the tattoos for me. It was just a little too much. I don't have any tattoos. I don't really plan on getting any either. So it was just that.
Okay. Right. I respect it.
So look
same
like
thing
snakes,
here. If you were to
bro.
Approach you, is he your type?
He's too short.
I would say depend on the setting.
Okay.
I would say I don't necessarily have like a physical type. I'm more of a vibes type of person. So it kind of depends on like how you approach me, what you say when you approach me.
Okay. Makes sense. All right. Sure. Let's go over here. Your name and age and why you ended up popping your balloon.
Damn, bro. There's only one 26. Guy with a balloon now.
It's just an attraction thing. Maybe it's the piercing. I don't know, but just
the piercing on the mouth. Yeah.
Yeah.
Either love it or you hate it.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
No, same thing here. If he were to approach you, is this something you would go for?
Yeah.
Mm. Everybody likes this nigga, bro.
All right, and we did get another pop back here.
Damn, son.
Right on over here, your name and age.
He probably
ended up popping your...
Yo, you know, this would be kind of shallow, bro. You'd be kind of scary. Be kind of shallow, bro, is that he didn't pop at first because he liked her, and then he saw the ass and was like, that shit would be crazy.
Yeah, Sylvester, 26. Same
why
thing,
he always do
attraction.
That?
You're very
he's
beautiful.
Like a gentle giant ass nigga, bro. He'd be like this. Whenever the questions get asked, he'd be like this.
Thank you.
He'd be like, Sylvester, you know, 26. Every single time. Sylvester, 26. Sylvester, I'm 26. Sylvester, I'm 26. Like, bro, always hunched over. Just bring the mic closer to my mouth, please, bro, because I can't take it no more, bro.
But, you know, obviously, it's going to be beautiful to somebody else.
YNW
so
Melly?
It's not myself.
Okay. So what is it?
Nothing specifically. It's just one of those, you know, like, if you know kind of things. Man, it's just not... My
and then he straightens up after the
for?
Like he starts yeah. answering the
got
question.
It. So same thing here. Is he your type?
Lester.
I would say no.
Okay.
And I feel like I wouldn't be just looking at you. I wouldn't think that I'm your type either.
Oh, okay. So why not for him?
Okay.
I don't know. You don't look like you date people that look like me.
What do people like?
What? Please don't do the whole dark skin thing, bro. Please don't do it. Don't do it. I don't think that was the case because he literally didn't pop the balloon when you first walked in. Please don't do the whole dark skin thing.
Look like you. What does that mean?
I don't know. You look like you might date another ethnicity.
No.
Oh my God, bro. Now she guilt tripping the nigga. Now she guilt tripping him, bro. If he didn't date like black people or dark skin or whatever the fuck you think, he would have popped a balloon when you walked in. Please believe.
No, I love my black queens. Don't get that wrong.
That's just my assumption looking at you.
Yeah, no, I feel that.
Okay. And now we do have one unpop balloon down there.
YNW fucking Melly. One unpop balloon. All right.
Your
fucking
name
Melly.
And age and why do you still have your balloon?
Kwan, I'm 29. Because we twins. The locks, girl.
That's
black excellence.
Automatically twins?
Black excellence. You heard me? Well, you...
I'm from Michigan.
Born and raised?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what's your nationality?
I'm African American.
Twins. Nah, but the reason why I left
Are
my
you from
balloon.
Michigan too?
No, hell no.
Damn,
girl,
okay.
I'm sorry. No disrespect.
I was going to say.
No,
Jesus Christ.
No disrespect. No disrespect.
Shout out to the men.
Nah, I'm from Florida. I was born in Jersey, but.
Where the fuck is Melly from? Is Melly from Broward? No, he's not from Broward, right? Melly from Atlanta, ain't he?
I'm from Florida. I live in South Florida, Palm Beach. Shout out. But the reason I left my balloon on pop, because you are beautiful.
I
love
that.
Your tattoos. I love your piercings. I know the next question is, do I have a question for you?
Exactly.
So here we go. You ready, Arlette?
We ready. Go ahead.
Why'd you leave my balloon on pop? What's up?
The question was, why did I leave my balloon on pop? Or why did I leave your balloon on pop?
Yeah. Am I your type?
I mean, I wouldn't say I left it on pop, because Will's like going through the line. But would I say that you're my type? I would say no.
That's respectable.
I'll make it a little bit.
Okay, so why is he not your type?
Get the.
I would say you just don't look like, or I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. You just don't look like someone that, I don't know. You just don't look like my type. Even though I said I don't have a type earlier, I don't know.
Right. I was going to ask you that. So how can someone not look like something you don't
have? Even though I have locks, I've never dated somebody with locks. Maybe.
Oh. See, I feel like when people say they don't got a type, they always be lying, bro. Sorry. Mini crash out.
That.
Okay.
Not that I have
that.
Anything wrong with it, but.
I respect you.
It's okay, bro.
That's respectable.
Well, she doesn't have a pick, so are you saying you want him to go ahead and pop?
Yeah, you can.
Okay, go ahead and pop. All right, thank you. Let's head on back.
He thought he had a match, bro. Nobody want Melly, bro. Okay. That's crazy. That's crazy for you to pop him when he's the only one who was really attracted to you, like, for real.
Hey, well, that is all of the balloons popped. We do thank you for coming on. I'll take this mic and let's give it up for her, guys.
I know Melly ain't wanna. I feel bad, bro. I feel bad. Melly almost had him a match, bro, and it just.
All right, let's go ahead and bring out our next single lady.
Hello,
welcome in. What's your name?
Anissa.
Anissa, how old are you?
I'm 23.
Okay, hi, and what Anissa. Do you do?
So I'm a licensed cosmetologist. I do hair and I do makeup.
Oh, cool. Mm-hmm. And what are some things that you do for fun?
So I like to just try new things. Like I love to like go to like museums. I love to like just try new things. Like just like go out, trying to like, you know, that's it. Just
okay.
Try new things. Yeah. I'm very
adventurous. Yo, she said like fucking 7 times, dog. Look, I'm not one to say that you can't say like when you're speaking, but when it's as if like is the only word you know how to use, it's kind of crazy. It's kind of crazy. She literally just did this, bro. So imagine I'm talking to you, like, and I, like, wanted to, like, say, like, I'm having a good, like, time. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's kind of, like, crazy. Do you see how fucking annoying that is? I couldn't, bro. I couldn't.
So
got it. Now what are some things you look for in a man?
You can say
someone
like sometimes, but damn,
like, that's my main thing, like respectful, kind-hearted, because I feel like I'm a really good person. Like I feel like I'm a kind person, someone who's nice, you know, kind and everything.
Yeah. Okay. What are some deal breakers?
Take a shot every time she says fucking like, bro. Golly.
I wouldn't say it's a deal breaker, but I would prefer someone who doesn't have kids, because I don't have kids.
Okay. Everybody says that's, that,
but
dude.
It's
you're
like,
not
I could work. I love
different.
Kids, so I could work with it, but that's really one of my things. Someone who is disrespectful. Like, if you're disrespectful, if you don't have respect for women, then that's my biggest deal breaker. Like, I don't like that. Like, oh, you know, that's it. Yeah,
not for me.
Yeah.
All right, so all the balloons are still unpopped.
Okay.
It's pretty good. So I am going to go ahead and hand you a pick.
Okay.
There you go. And I'm going to have you pop 3 balloons.
Why?
Blue's not really your usual type. Whatever it is, you're not feeling, go ahead and pop those three.
Okay.
Why are you doing 3? Narrow her options down.
Sorry.
And wow. Okay, 2 more.
It's hard. Okay.
Sorry. It's always those more. 2 niggas.
One more? 3?
Yeah, 3. Uh-huh. Oh.
It's always those 2, I swear.
I'm sorry. Sorry, I feel bad.
All right, we'll start here since okay. He's right here. Your name and age?
My name's Daytrin. I'm 27.
Okay. And Daytrin, why was your balloon unpopped?
She's just very beautiful. I like that she is doing something for herself. And I just wanted to keep hearing her out. So. Okay.
Thank you.
And why did we end up popping his?
It's not my usual type. That's all. Like someone like, you know, just wouldn't really like, I don't know, like it wouldn't really go for it. But you seem nice. You look very nice. You look very handsome.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
We did get one over here.
I'm going to count every time
your
she says like.
Your name and age and why was your balloon unpopped?
Matthew, I'm 26. And I liked your answers. You seem like you have a good head on your shoulders. Nice smile. So,
thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. So why did we end up popping his?
Just not my usual type, that's all.
Okay, so what was it about him that doesn't fall into that type?
It's really just like, and it's probably like a little petty, I just don't like nose piercing, like, a guy's a nose piercing, I'm sorry, that's all.
2 other dudes with nose piercing.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay, so let's head back this way. Your name and age and why you ended up popping.
Yeah, Sylvester, 26, I have a nose piercing.
Every fucking time this nigga says something, he leans over. Yeah, Sylvester, that shit's pissing me off. I don't know why.
So okay. I want to respect your rules.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so before
that. I
didn't
realize you had one.
So before that, why did you have your balloon unpopped?
I'm wanting to hear her out. You know, she's into something and, you know, I wanted to know if she's running, you know, planning on running her own practice. Mm-hmm. I like to push and motivate, so that's my thing.
Got it. So he does have the nose ring, but is he someone that's your type?
He is someone that would be my type.
Mm-hmm. That's too bad, bitch. She said no nose ring.
Don't let the nose ring go.
Yeah, I mean, like, because it was just like, I don't know why. I'm sorry. I know this probably, like, I like the ring more than like the little.
Oh, so you like the.
Yeah, I feel like, because I used to have the little, like for the girls, like the little.
See, stud, I like the ring. Stud.
I don't know. Maybe it's just like.
I like the stud if I was going to get a nose piercing.
I don't like yeah, yeah, the yeah, like,
she no, likes the ring.
You get a pass. So what do you think?
I'll take my balloon back.
Let's get that balloon back.
I'll take my balloon back. W, nigga.
There we go. All right, so we'll be back then. Let's go down over here. Okay.
I know that nigga mad, bro. He's like, bro, she really popped me on a nose ring, but just let this nigga slide who also has a nose ring. Yo.
Your name and age and why you ended up popping.
I'm Justin, 26.
Nose ring.
Okay. Why'd you pop, Justin?
The nose ring comment.
Yeah.
I have a nose ring, so I didn't think
but
she
it's
would,
also a hoop.
She would like it. Yeah.
Okay. But prior to her saying that, you did have your balloon unpopped. Why?
Yeah, I thought she was pretty. I wanted to hear more of what she had to say. So.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. So is he someone that's your type?
No, not typically my type. But you are very nice looking. You look very nice.
Okay. And so what about him specifically?
It's just the shoes a little bit. It's not really my
shoes. Oh, it's the shoes.
I'm sorry, but they don't look bad. I just would like with the outfit. I just like I look for like you know, this
cope aesthetic
different.
Cool.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. So let's start with your name.
I can agree with her, bro. Now, I'm not necessarily saying his shoes are dirty. Maybe they are like brand new, but they have that like dirty aesthetic to it, which is fucking wild because that is an aesthetic. People think dirty shoes is like an aesthetic and it looks cool. I think that shit is fucking stupid, bro. Like, if you're out on a town and you're wearing, like, beaters, or, like, if you go into a club and you're wearing beaters because you know niggas gonna step on your shit, fine. But, like, let's say you need to step out. Like, you need to pop out on these. You need to pop out and show niggas. Imagine, and you decide to wear dirty beater shoes because that's your style. Fuck no, bro.
An age?
Fuck no.
27.
Okay. And, John, so you actually had your balloon unpopped. Why so?
I just wanted to hear her out, see what she had to say, things like that.
Okay. So is she someone that is your type, though?
I would have to hear more, you know, so I just wanted to wait to see what you had to say.
Okay.
So you actually ended up popping his. Mm-hmm. Why?
Just, like, off initial attraction. Just, that's all.
Off but initial you,
like,
attraction.
You look nice. Just,
she
like,
might be from New York.
Type. I like a guy a little bit more taller. That's all.
Okay. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Right. She sounds like a New York. Wait, is this taking place in New York? I don't know if this was ever said, but like obviously this is my first time watching Pop the Balloon. Is this shit in New York?
Heck. So we have three balloons left unpopped. Let's go ahead and ask these remaining guys a question to see who's more of your match.
Okay. What are like three words you would describe yourself like in a relationship? Like how you are.
Breath of fresh air.
Okay, let's start down there and work our way up.
Okay.
Okay, let's start with your name and age and three words you would use to describe
yourself.
My God,
Melly didn't get a pop.
My name is Quan. Mm-hmm. I'm a leader, family oriented, and I will say outgoing.
Okay.
Quan, how old are you?
I'm 29. I'm sorry about that.
Okay. Nigga said I'm sorry about that.
Your name and age and the answer to her question.
Gerard, 26. I'd say empathetic, romantic, and yeah, I'd have to say leader. Like him, I hate to steal his answer, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And then our last guy up
Both
here.
Both of them got them Apple Watch Ultras on.
I think we got your name and age earlier, but if you want to tell her again, you definitely can, along with answer to her question.
Yeah, Sylvester, 26. Same things. He said empathetic, understanding, and nurturing. I'm somebody that likes to provide, so you know, if you fit the type, then I'm there.
Okay, so we do have to pop a balloon.
That fucking smacking shit pissing me off.
Whose balloon are you popping?
Fucking.
I'm sorry.
Is it Melly? Oh my
God. Okay, so why did we end up popping his?
Just like, I don't know. I like the other people's answers more. Like, just they answered more. That's all. Okay. Because you seem very nice. Like, you seem
No. They got the same answer, though. So what did you like?
I don't know. It's just the way, I don't know. It's just.
So honesty, mm-hmm. What did you like?
I liked the, like, what I like or what I didn't like.
What did you like and what did, like, what, they got the same answers. I want to know what you ain't like.
Not really, though. Like, he said he was nurturing. Like, you know, like, I didn't really use that.
They said the same thing. What you say? I said I'm a leader, family oriented. And what was the third one? I forgot mine. I did.
But I just remember the family oriented and the first one you said. That's
what was the first one I said?
The first
leader. The leader I said was third. I know I said leader. Third.
No, I think you said the leader. You said something in the beginning. You said something to me.
It's all good. Yeah, thank you. All
right. So you had your balloon unpopped for her. Why so?
Because she's really attractive.
Oh, thank you.
Like, girl, look at
you. Oh,
thank you. Out of everybody that came out tonight, Aunt Viv. But nah.
Not Viv.
The age kind of scared me. What you said, 23?
Yeah, you said 29, so that was another thing I was gonna say.
Yeah, so that age kind of, it's like a gap there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You still got to experience life.
I'm very much
6 year difference, though.
From my age, though.
Subjective, but go ahead.
Okay. I
Subjective.
Like that.
Look at this nigga over here in the corner. He's trying his best not to laugh too. Why this nigga gotta be brooding, bro? Why he gotta have like a brooding fucking outgo, like brooding energy about him? He don't wanna laugh, like. Bro be trying his hardest not to laugh. Look at him, bro.
Okay. I respect that.
Look at like the slight smirk. Thank you. And then straight back to nonchalant. So. What's that future song that they be playing with them TikToks?
Any questions for our girl? Any questions for our girl?
Yeah.
You got a question? Okay, let's go.
Same one as the last. Ask the last one. So whenever you're going through a tough situation, like, what is something you tell yourself to pull yourself out of that?
That I'm like, I'm a strong, beautiful woman. Like, I've been through like the worst of the worst, and I still came up out of that. So, I tell myself that I could make it through anything. If I make it through one thing, I can make it through anything.
Okay, I like that.
Okay.
That's cool.
Let's go down here.
That's a decent answer.
Any questions here?
Yeah, so this first one is quick. I hear you have an accent. Where are you from?
I'm from New Jersey.
Okay, yeah, I hear it. And the other question is, so when you're in a relationship, how do you show your partner that you care about them?
I love to cook. But I know that like food is the one way to a man, like the main way to a man's heart. So
I agree.
I like to cook.
I mean, sure, but
okay, you good?
Yeah.
All right.
It's not the only way.
Okay, girl, it is time to pop. We have two lovely gentlemen left.
Oh, this is so hot.
I know, I bet it is, but we do have to pop a balloon.
Okay.
Hey, somebody pop for her. She's thinking.
Okay. You want to pop it yourself? Because you seem like you was about to pop it just now. I'm sorry.
Okay, so why did we end up popping his?
I just, like, honestly, I just feel like I would just connect with him more just, like, that way. That's all. Like, but you're very attractive. Like, it was really hard to decide.
That's respectable.
You know, and everything.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Nice. So that's why was your balloon unpopped for her?
She, her voice is calming. Like, it just... And then you say you can cook.
Yeah.
I eat a lot. So. So, yeah. And then you're attractive.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
No problem.
That's a solid answer. Just being like, you know what? My connection with him was a little bit stronger. That's totally fine.
Let's head on back. All right. Come on up here. Come on up. Come on up. All right, y'all. Any look, y'all even wearing brown together? Let me slow down. Any final questions between the two of you?
Do you plan on opening your own practice soon?
Yes, that's my goal. I want to open up like a huge like spa type hair salon, everything. Like that's my goal.
That's my only question.
You're good. Okay. So then is it a yes for you for her?
Yeah.
All right. And is it a yes for you for him? We got him!
All right, we got another one.
Take this mic. Look, you already, she still has my mic.
She still has my mic.
I'll take that. You guys go on up. Let's give it up for them, y'all.
Good shit, guys. For real. Good shit. We got two matches.
All right, let's go ahead and bring out our next single lady.
Damn, it's only six guys now.
Hello, welcome in. What's your name?
Shalia.
Shalia, how old are you?
I'm 24.
And what do you do?
So I'm in banking. I'm in finance.
Okay, nice. What are some things you like to do for fun?
For fun, I like to hike, and I'm very active. So
you know what's kind of crazy about her saying that she's a banker, bro? She looked like that banker that Lawrence had a little relationship with in the first season of Insecure.
I like to like go
or was
on,
it the
like,
second
hikes
season?
And
whenever Issa cheated on that nigga
to the gym
and he got with that
like
banker
that.
Okay
yeah.
Now what are some of your deal breakers?
Look just like her.
My deal breakers would be someone who's not like active going to like church. Even if you're not like physically going to church, that's fine, but if you're not like virtually going as well, that's kind of like a deal breaker.
Every Sunday or
no, not every Sunday.
Okay.
Just like as long as you're virtually going and you're actively trying to like,
I'm not going to bring religion into this because I'm not going to have this discussion with niggas on the internet. But I think hold on, I just lost my fucking train of thought. I'm sorry, y'all. I think following God is enough, bro. I feel like going to church doesn't show that you're faithful. You can go to church and still be a trifling ass nigga, bro. It's possible. You can go to church every Sunday and then do dirty deeds all throughout the week. You know what I mean? And you could never go to church and be like an outstanding citizen. You know what I'm saying?
Deepen your relationship with God and stuff, that's fine.
Okay.
I feel like church is not the all answer for everything.
All right, so we did get some pop balloons. Okay. Let's go on over there to see why they ended up popping.
Now, I'm not saying I'm opposed to church. I mean, I used to go to church, too.
My name's Daytrin. I'm 27.
When I lived with my mom, I used to go to church every Saturday.
It's just because you want someone that, you know, actively goes or, you know, virtually. I do believe there is a God. I praise God on my own time. I pray to him. Grew up in a church as an adult life with my job. I can't get to church, you know, as often as I would like. But I do believe there is a God, but I'm not active.
Even virtually?
I'm not active virtually.
Oh, okay.
Like I said, I just, you know, I praise him on my own time.
Okay.
Which I feel like is fine.
So now, is he someone that's your type?
Yeah, I kind of like his style a little bit. He seems well-spoken, so that's good as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm, let's go to our next guy over here.
You know what
your
they said.
Name
can't
and
go
age
to church.
And why you ended up popping your balloon.
I'm Matthew, I'm 26. And
deal breaker.
I read scripture every day, but I just don't think that I'm as far along in my faith journey as you might want me to be. So I just want for you to find someone that might be better for you in that sense. So yeah.
Okay.
So is he someone that's your type?
For sure.
Okay.
Damn, nigga. damn, nigga, she looked good and she was into you, bro. All
right. And
hey, I want my balloon back.
So we got four unpopped balloons. Let's go ahead and ask these remaining guys a question to help us narrow it down.
He's wearing a Deacon vest. That's why she's into him.
Let's see who's more of your type.
So my question would be, what do you guys define success
Brother
as?
Brother Deacon.
What do you define?
Question would be, what do you guys define success as?
That's a decent question.
What do you define success as? Let's start here with your name and age and the answer to your question.
I'm Justin, 26. I say I define success as fulfilling your goals and what you want to do. So for me personally, fulfilling the goals that I have in my life. And then I think at the end of all of that, it's just being happy. If your goals don't lead to like happiness or fulfillment in your life, then I mean, I don't think they're great goals. So I would say success is fulfilling your goals and being happy at the end of everything.
Okay, let's go to our next guy. Your name and age and the answer to her question.
My name is John, I'm 27. I would define success, there are two paths in life. I think there's what God wants and I think there's what we want. And I think success is finding a way to align balance your path with what God wants, no matter how hard it is, how difficult it looks, how much you might not like it. I think finally finding a way to align your path with God's path is the true definition of success, regardless of how much money you make or what kind of car you drive, the clothes you wear. All that is nice, don't get me wrong, but you know, when you align yourself with God's path, regardless of anything, I think that's success.
Alright. Name and age and answer.
I agree. I feel like finding a balance though. I mean, question. I don't know.
I'm Gerard, I'm 26. So I think it's different for every person. For me, it's I figured out what I like to do and ultimately what I want to be known for when I die. And that's for helping people improve and specifically minorities. If I can, I wish I had the opportunities that I can give them by mentoring. So I think success is figuring out your passion and then doing everything you can do to accomplish that or work towards it.
And our last guy, name and age, and how do you define success?
How are you? My name is Quan. I'm 29. I love your smile.
Thank you.
Okay, so success to me is pretty much accomplishing what God has put out forth for you, pleasing Him, your family, your foundation, your values, everything. So success to me is achieving the top.
He's sitting back there like, this nigga stole my fucking answer.
I use everything. So success to me is achieving the top of the top.
Okay, let's head on back. So I'm going to now hand you a pick and you're gonna pop one of these guys' balloons. So let me hand you a pick.
Okay.
There you go. And go ahead and pop one of them.
Okay.
Why was the camera on him like that?
Sorry guys, nothing personal. There we go.
All right, let's go.
Damn, yo, Melly ain't getting no play, bro.
Come over here.
None. All right,
so Quan, why did you have your balloon unpopped for her?
The attraction, the initial attraction. I think the question she asked was kind of, like, generic.
Broad.
But it was a great question. Anything involving God is immaculate. So, but I just think that, you know, your initial attraction, you're really attractive. I told you that off rip, the eye contact. Mm-hmm. I think you're really pretty, but... You know, I just wanted to hear more of what you had to ask or the answer that I would have, the answer to the question I would ask you.
So why did we end up popping his?
I just think the initial attraction, just typically like what I go off of is like not there. So,
okay.
Yeah.
I respect that. That's your opinion.
But you're very handsome and very attractive. I'm glad. Glad you know. That's
yeah,
good.
Girl.
You got it.
But no, I respect your opinion. Thank you again for the honesty.
I'm not gonna lie, nigga. This is probably why you don't get matched. Like, you're really like, I don't know. He's really like aggressive, low key, bro. When that one bitch said that the other nigga was combative, which was wildly incorrect, I would have said it with this guy probably. He always got something to say back.
Thank you. Okay, we've got maybe three guys left. Let's ask them another question.
Another question.
Sorry.
Another question would be, how do you face, like, what do you do to face challenges in your everyday life? Like, how do you keep going?
Okay, ready?
That is a great question.
Yeah.
Okay.
To face challenges in my everyday life, I think a big thing is being self-motivated. So I try to do, like, a lot of reflection on where I think I'm at, like, in my life right now. And just, like, set realistic goals, set realistic plans for...
Getting Gucci third leg on this would be crazy.
To, like, get
instant pops.
Get to where I feel like I'm at a point where I'm fulfilled and where I feel like I'm happy. So I feel like when I'm in a rut, it's like just coming up with a plan and like, just coming up with a plan to get back there.
Okay. Next guy.
Yeah, two things. The first thing is understanding that there's somebody who is looking out for me that has already seen all challenges and sees the way. I know that God is looking out for me. So taking it to him, praying, making sure I'm good. So I try to compartmentalize, you know, and understand that there are people out there that are going through worse things than I am.
Yes, sir.
As well. And so just keeping those two things in mind, that I have God out for me and I have people that, you know, it could be worse. So
it can always be worse.
That keeps me motivated and I just keep on going after that.
That's how I keep going. I'm not gonna lie, bro. Like, it is what it is. It can always be worse.
So first, I seek out challenges. That's what helps me grow. Discipline. That's the one thing you need to conquer any challenge. As long as you're disciplined, you'll eventually conquer that challenge. Yeah.
That's the truth.
All right.
True statement.
It is time to pop. Who's
me?
Yeah, it's time to pop another balloon. So whose balloon are we popping?
This is a tough one. Can I ask one more question? Just a quick question.
After this round.
Okay. She's really strict about that.
You guys are all very good looking and like very well spoken. So I'm sorry. It's nothing personal.
Okay, I know it's really, really tough. So why did we end up popping his?
Yeah, it was really tough. I honestly just had to narrow down, but your answer was great, and you're very well-spoken, and you're very well-dressed. I just had to narrow it down. So it's nothing personal.
Yeah, no, I'm not taking it like that.
Okay.
All right, so why did you have your balloon unpopped for her?
I thought she was very pretty. I like
why he stand like that?
She was asking.
I've been noticing it the whole episode, but haven't said anything. I just think, like, why does he stand like that?
So, two remaining guys, any questions for our lady here? Okay, go ahead.
So can you tell me about your relationship with God?
So my relationship with God, I grew up in a Christian church. Just my mom going to like a Christian denomination.
Bro might actually get a match here, bro.
My relationship with God, I try to focus on reading the Bible. I actually have like a little thing where like I flip through the Bible and I try to like let God land me where he wants to land me.
Sure.
So whatever scripture he has for me at that moment, then I try to read that scripture.
Who's your favorite Bible character?
Oh, that's a good one. Honestly, so I grew up watching like the Prince of Egypt or Joseph and everything. So I think my favorite would be Prince of Egypt because he had a lot of battles, but he overcome that.
All right, I'm not like trying to like cause something, nothing, but Moses is also my favorite character as well in the Bible. Yeah.
Okay. Did you ever seen the Prince of Egypt?
Yeah. I watched that as a little kid.
That's a great movie.
And I had the little book where you flip through and it was like the pictures and everything.
Right?
Yeah.
So. Same vibe.
Any he got gave himself a match.
Yeah. So I didn't want to pop while you were speaking about God, but I'm really not on that. I'm not gonna say level. I do give everything I accomplish the glory to God, but I'm definitely not on the level that it seems like you're looking for of my religious journey. So. I was going to pop right there, but I just felt like it was disrespectful talking about God.
But I have a question, though.
Okay, yeah. You can
so are you, like, open to learning about God, or you're just, like, shut off about it?
Oh, yeah, definitely open to learning.
Okay.
My dad, shout out to him, super religious, always keep me on it. But, yeah, I think I've just been super zoned in and focused. So I haven't been to church or virtual in about a year or two, so it just depends on what you want.
Do you read the Bible?
Not really. Okay. No. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's up to you.
I'm glad you didn't pop. Let's give her a chance. Yeah. Okay. So based off of what you've heard, what you see, whatever it is, we are down to our final two guys. Whose balloon are you going to be popping?
He's popping yours. Yeah. You know she's popping yours.
You just take his. Oh, look at them all offering. Look at these gentlemen.
Very chivalrous.
Chivalrous?
You just take his. Oh, look at them all offering. Look at these gentlemen.
Very chivalrous.
Oh, she said they're very chivalrous. Girl, the word is chivalrous. Chivalrous. Chivalrous is... chivalrous sounds like a disgusting word, actually. They're so chivalrous.
All right. So, once again, I know it's really tough. Why did we end up going with him?
Just because of the answer, just because it seems like you're not really, like, on the path, the same path as I'm on.
People's
like,
going to pop for that, not, too.
Like, there exactly with your relationship with God, but, like, still trying to, like, learn and progress is the main thing.
Yeah. Yeah. I understand that.
All right. Thank you. Okay. Come on up here. Look at, he got this little fashion walk going.
He finally got himself a little match. Took right, the jacket off.
Any final wasn't working for him. The two of you?
No, I'm good.
I think I'm good.
Okay. Well, then, is it going to be a yes for you?
That's the same thing, yeah. The jacket.
Is it a yes for you for him? Yes. We got a match.
Okay.
I'll take this mic, and you guys can go on off. They don't need it anymore. All right, y'all. Let's give it up for them. Let's give it up. If you'd like to be featured in any of our upcoming episodes, go ahead and click on the link in the description box below and fill out the submission form to be considered.
Yeah, they were all pretty good.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. All these men were like pretty cool. And we'll catch you all next time.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie, bro. I did crash out a little bit. But I also can't say that, like, that was bad. I can't sit here and say that was actually as bad as I thought it would be. Wasn't too bad, bro.